When criminals in this world appear and break the laws that they should fear and frighten all who see or hear, the cry goes up both far and near for underdog.
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 Cut the Kate on that, yeah.
Underdog. Speed of lightning, roar of thunder.
Okay, so folks, this is the underdog theme song. It's 7:14 for you numerologists. Welcome to Reform School. My name is Bob Bowden, and we'll get to that cameo performer in a second. Let's talk about the news of the day. And first, we're going to go here. It's the Choice Media Education Calendar, where we have all kinds of events. It's the only thing like it in the world. If you want to find out about webinars and national conferences pertaining to education, choicemedia.tv. Also, we'll be covering this, why schools' efforts to block the internet are so laughably lame. Kids seem to just crack these iPads in seconds. Also, Washington State teachers saying, you know what, we should have a referendum about statewide class sizes. Let's do that. Also, this story, it is a palace intrigue, is the term I've been using, in Louisiana, as Bobby Jindal and John White, what the you know, formerly handpicked John White by Bobby Jindal, now suing the governor. Also, this in Newark, we see that charters catching on fast. What this is when you ask parents in Newark to pick the schools they want for their kids, even though the establishment, many of the union members there trash charters, oh my gosh, the parents seem to pick them. This, speaking of Newark, opponents protesting superintendent's contract renewal. This in Minnesota, which is about a story about interventions and special needs and whether certain races are overrepresented in places like St. Paul and Minneapolis. The feds think so. And, well, we'll get to that in a second. First, again, I'm Bob Bowden. Thanks for joining us. To my right, Chris Dobergos on the two-shot should, yes, and indeed, there he is, framed, I would say, on nearly perfectly, that two-shot today. We also have Heather Kays from the corner, who, and Heather, everything good with you over there?
Yep, everything's good.
It's the new lighting for Heather, everybody. Most importantly, we have the person you saw a second ago, the great Kate Baker, joining us from the Network for Educational Opportunity in the great state of New Hampshire, where I believe the slogan is to live free or die, and I presume Kate is living free. Kate, thanks for your time on today's Reform School.
Happy to be here.
All right. In fact, let's take a look at a website right now I have pulled up called networkforeducation.org. Look at that. It's based in New Hampshire. Scholarship and tax credit information. Oh, that sounds like they're Oh, look at that picture. Kate Baker, executive director. It looks like they're looking to drain money from the public schools so that they can line the pockets of billionaires. Kate, tell us, what is the Network for Educational Opportunity?
The Network for Educational Opportunity is an education resource and scholarship organization. We are the only organization operating here on the ground in New Hampshire with our education tax credit scholarship program, which is currently being challenged in our Supreme Court. And we've been fighting that battle for about a year. So it's pretty exciting here in New Hampshire. Mm-hmm. Parents really are looking for education opportunities. We've had more than 1,500 children apply for scholarships, really proving that demand that families are ready to make choices. It's just really time in New Hampshire here for the New Hampshire Supreme Court to give us that opportunity to do that work.
How many millions have you put into artwork for your office? It looks like it's lavishly decorated there in the wall behind you. And well, and the furniture, no doubt you've hired professionals to come in for professional interior decor.
That's right. You're dispelling that myth that school choice is associated with, and somehow with corporate America, which doesn't make, I mean, any sense to me. I'm actually a free and reduced lunch kid from an urban area in New Hampshire, really working in New Hampshire to help people who, frankly, are in my situation, a kid that otherwise wouldn't have a choice. Otherwise may not be able to go to a school that meets their needs. And so I really see our effort to help families and parents really as grassroots.
And one last thing, you know, there were some that would say New Hampshire, you know, everybody's nice there. It's a smaller population. There's no serious pushback. No one would be mean to Kate Baker, right?
I think anytime you introduce a different idea, or you want to facilitate change, you know, there will be pushback. I mean, in New Hampshire, you know, the people that sued the state over the education tax credit, I mean, frankly, it's the NEA and the AFT and the School Boards Association. I mean, people really want to maintain the status quo, and I really don't care if they want to maintain the status quo. I'm more concerned about helping a child today.
They want to protect the adults, really, the jobs of adults, in other words.
I'm going to help the kids anyway, and there's families that call me, you know, a child with autism who would prefer a smaller school environment. It makes perfect sense for me to help that child to be able to go to a smaller school that better meets their needs. And frankly, we're just going to keep doing it.
Yep.
And keep raising money and keep helping low-income children who otherwise, again, would be totally constrained by their zip code. How is that American? How is that, you know, not discriminatory, frankly, to be assigned to a school that might not meet your needs because of your socioeconomic status? I mean, that's what we want to do here? I don't think so. I think children should go to the school that meets their needs. I don't care where they live.
All right, let's talk about some specifics of the day, starting with a Slate story. Kate, I know you saw this. It basically, it talks about how lots of kids in schools around the country are getting free iPads and getting computers, sometimes laptops to take home. And what they do is they'll put special software on these computers to block the internet or block social media sites. And so what this is all about, it's a larger conversation. It's happening in a lot of places where, well, for example, in Los Angeles, where 600,000 iPads are being given to kids. And they say, yeah, go ahead and try to block these social media sites or sometimes porn sites. And in 2 seconds, the kids get around the alleged software that is supposed to block their access. And so where do you stand on this?
This is a similar problem to bullying, though, in that when you have a relationship with a child, then they are engaged with you and they're most likely to be learning and doing things that are productive. And so to me, it's almost just a question of adult supervision and engagement rather than necessarily the device, if that makes sense. For example, your kids could watch things on TV that may or may not be appropriate, but if I'm sitting there with them, I mean, how likely is it that they'll make a poor choice with their mother sitting next to them?
It's a big difference, yeah. But I guess I'm just—I'm skeptical when I see money thrown at education rather than other kind of structural reforms. And so we are seeing this a lot of places, though. But other people, you know, like here at Choice Media, sometimes think that, well, the computers are just the new version of textbooks. And so,
well, computers are already there. We're talking about iPads and stuff.
Yeah.
But a little tip for the kids out there.
Computers.
What we used to do when I was in school, they would block different searches on Google. So all you really have to do is go to Google Australia. Then you can Google whatever you want.
Yeah.
So if you're listening, kids, that's the way to do it.
Right. So So the point is that I want to get to a broader question, Kate, which is not about the blocking software, but simply whether you think, you know, buying kids their own iPads and laptops they can take home, whether you think that makes sense versus having the kids use the products at school.
I think that it does make sense to have it at school, I guess.
Okay. All right. I guess we'll leave it at that.